Hi, I'm Joe Gomez, centre-back for Liverpool. You're watching Uncut on the Premier League YouTube channel.
And we're going to kick things off with Aiden LFC, who has asked, you joined in 2015 when you had just turned 18 years old. How have you developed on and off the pitch over the years?
Yeah, I had to grow up pretty quickly. From the basics, paying bills and all those petty things that you don't think of. Then I got injured quite early, quite bad, and then that made me like wisen up about how I need to be professionally, and just life in general gave me a lot of time to think. So yeah, then after that on the pitch, yeah, I just use that time to learn. Obviously I've had good inspiration around me, the likes of Virgil, and that's the benefit of being somewhere like this. So yeah, I think I've just evolved as a person more so, I think, in terms of just learning how to manage myself and dealing with pressure, dealing with expectation and the psychological battles coming back from injuries and not feeling yourself. So yeah, a lot of ups and downs, but yeah, I wouldn't change it.
Okay, so Dr. Soccer asks, who's the toughest player you've ever played against?
See, like with this, I think there's differences in terms of who gave me the toughest time and who's the toughest player overall. Like it's easy for me to say Messi, because he's probably the best and one of the best ever. But when I've played fullback, like that's when I fight, it's harder. Like individual battles, the likes of Sane.
That's a Super Bowl. Sane away from Gomez. Leroy Sane has crashed it in and City a level.
The quick winger is tricky. That's probably one that comes to mind. Like
Paul Simpson has asked, you've achieved so much with Liverpool already. What else would you like to achieve that you haven't?
I think it's always just striving for more. I think obviously as a team, we want to keep creating history and win more trophies. And I think on a personal level, for me, it's more just establishing like appearances, playing well over a long period and just playing as many games as I can for the club. At times I felt like opportunities have been cut short when I've got injured and so on. So yeah, to play freely and yeah, just keep trying to help the team as best as possible. Sort of thing.
515 Naresh Kumar asks, do you have any superstitions that you do before or after the game?
I can't say like any mad ones. Like, I know some players, I won't.
Don't tell us who it is, but what do they do?
Just little things like with their shoes, like unorthodox things. To be fair, I like putting on one side. Like I know some lads need a certain playlist and certain. There was times when I started to get into a little routines, like, oh, like I feel like I need to do this, listen to this song at certain times, but I broke out of it. And there's times where I've listened to an album before a game and had a mare and then I can't listen to that again.
What's the album?
It was a J. Cole album one time.
Oh no, that's
I think
a shame.
It might have, yeah.
Because we like J. Cole.
I've listened to it again.
I made a mistake.
I think it was against Arsenal a few years ago. And I thought, nah, it must have been.
Danny Boy has asked, if you weren't a centre-back, what position would you like to play?
Probably midfield, like a holding midfielder. And even there, yeah, I'm not saying I could play holding midfield. I think I would enjoy that part of the game, like being on the ball and being involved in the game a lot.
So last season asks, you're very popular in FIFA 22 because of your 81 pace. Are you happy with that rating?
I think it's gone down, so I'm not really happy about that. I think it could be better. Yeah, like people say it to me like, oh, your ultimate team card is good. But yeah, no, I appreciate that like people use me, but I don't appreciate that FIFA put me down.
So what rating do you think it should be?
I think you're faster than Virgil.
I think me and Virg would give, like, Mo's probably got higher speed than us.
Yeah.
The distance in our ratings, I don't think the race would.
You think you could beat Mo in a race?
No, I'm not saying that, but I'm just saying.
It's tighter than people think, right?
Yeah. Virg is quick as well. Like, if the ratings, like, between Mo and Virg is like 87 to 81 or whatever, it's like, some of the FIFA's ratings in real life scenarios, I don't think are that correct, but that's another story.
Raheem Sterling receives a 90 rated Team of the Week left wing item. With 93 pace and 89 dribbling, we would recommend a marksman chemistry style to go ahead and increase the shooting, dribbling and physicality. Philippe Coutinho receives an 84 rated Team of the Week item with 90 dribbling and 83 passing. We would recommend a hunter chemistry style to increase the pace and the shooting stats.
We're going to ask you to choose five Premier League players from the past or present to build your perfect squad. We're going to start off with goalkeeper.
There's been a lot of legends, I think. But like, I will probably end up incorporating a lot of current just because of the players that we've had. I think for me, Ali is unbelievable. I think he, as a person, but as a goalkeeper, I think he can do everything.
I agree.
Yeah, you quite your degree.
I'm a Liverpool supporter.
Oh, you are. Yeah,
so, and Alisson's the best. He's the best.
I don't think there's anything in his game that you can, any way you could dispute what he's done and how good he is. So,
yeah.
Quick say, Ali.
All right, defender.
Obviously, Liverpool has some great centre halves like Carragher, Hippier, Daniel, like so on. But for me, Virg, I think, is going to be looked at in the all-time Premier League greats, let alone Liverpool. So I've said on record, like for me, Rio was an inspiration to me, being from South East, the career he had, his style of play. Yeah, for sure, he's up there. But yeah, for me, I still think Virg is capable of being in that category.
Yeah.
Midfielder.
I think I've got Stevie G.
There is Gerrard. Can he get on the score sheet? Reads the West Ham defenders a dance! And that is an absolute bullet.
He obviously had a lot of pressure on his shoulders, but like he channeled that, it seems, like in a way that meant he left it all on the pitch. As a player, like looking at his mentality, I think that's so big in the game.
Yeah. And what's your mentality when you come out onto the pitch? What's going through your mind?
I try and be quite present. I've had conversations with some players on our team whereby they're so far in their subconscious, they can't even have a conversation. Like, it's just things like meditation and so on. I think applying those things help in scenarios. It's a high pressure scenario at the end of the day.
Okay, we're on to the striker section.
For me, like when I was young, I think it was like my age, like the sweet spot at that point in time was Thierry Henry.
Some of the best attacking players on view here. Thierry Henry, high on that list. And here he is! Oh. What a start!
Like the charisma that he played with, like his swag, his whole aura.
You didn't like, put up socks as well, yeah?
I couldn't though. Like, it's not.
That was one of your superstitions.
Nah, there's certain people can pull that off and certain people can't. But in the present, I think things that Mo are doing, we'll look back on and be like, this is unbelievable. And I feel like sometimes things aren't appreciated till they're gone. I don't know. I'd probably have to tie those two.
It's only one name. Only one name. The pressure's on, Joe.
I'll say Mo. I have to go and sit next to him in the dressing room after this. So.
That's Mo.
I'll say Mo, yeah.
So what's it like training with him then?
Yeah, some days it's long. Like, if you're not up for it, you've got no chance. Yeah, you're going to get twisted inside out by Mo, Sadio, Bobby, all of them. Imagine early rehab, pre-season, like my first sessions back and trying to get up to speed and then Mo. It's difficult, but that's why we're here, and that's why all of us in this team aspire to be at Liverpool.
All right, and finally, wild card. Any position that you want to add to the team?
I think Trent and Robbo like are being appreciated for what they've done, and I think they're already in that category of top five, like the way people are talking. But I think on everyone's list up there was Ashley Cole. Before, I think fullback was like just try and survive, defend, win your battles. But like to actually affect the game going forward the way they do now, I think Ashley Cole when he was playing. One of the best at it, so.
That's a strong squad.
I'm here for it.
Yeah, it's not bad, isn't it?
Kieran Trippier receives an 86 rated Team of the Week item with 82 defending and 84 passing. We would recommend an anchor chemistry style to increase the pace, defensive and physicality stats. James Ward-Prowse receives his second Team of the Week item this season. Coming in at 86 rated with 92 passing and 84 dribbling, we would recommend a shadow chemistry style to increase the pace and defensive stats. Let us know down below in the comment section which one of these Team of the Week items makes it into your FIFA Ultimate Team.
You're going to be playing against Everton.
Okay.
You've got to try and score a goal as quick as possible, but you've got Trent's score to beat. Of 32 seconds.
Yeah.
Okay. Come on, Jots.
Liverpool versus Everton.
Okay. Oh no! Jota went for it.
I've rushed it. Is the time running?
Yeah, still running.
Oh my day. Verge.
On the end of this.
This is ridiculous.
You got this.
Oh no, I can't be losing the ball now. So this counts as time as well,
This is time. Trent. All right. Oh no!
This is ridiculous. What's he doing? This ain't semi-pro.
There you go.
Man, he's in behind.
All right.
That's a great ball.
Oh!
He's gonna finish his dinner.
That's the one. I should have just relied on him in the first place. Jots is letting me down, man.
Billy, we're talking about Mo this whole time.
And I'm running with Jots.
I celebrated like this was a real game, by the way.
Nah, I appreciate it. Jots' finishing is a joke.
Well done.
Should have been a lot earlier, to be fair.